Even if you've just been in church a few weeks, you've probably heard lists of things to do, you know, like three steps to a better marriage. You've heard five steps to a better this, a better that, a better prayer life. You've heard of Christian cookbooks and biblical diets. I mean, it seems like we can't even have dinner without getting a preacher involved. But, you know, Christianity is not supposed to be like that. It's really supposed to be about relaxing with God. And that's why I wrote this book. I wrote this book to show people that all the many messages they may have heard throughout their lifetime telling them to do more and be more for God and it never, ever being enough, well, that's not God's attitude toward us. That may make for some easy sermon preparation, but in the end, what we're really called to is rest. I mean, just think about it. The fruit of the Spirit, where is love and peace and patience going to come from anyway? Is it going to come from me in some anxious state as I try to crank out some good-looking behavior for God? The fruit of the Spirit is soft. It comes from a place of softness. It comes from an attitude of relaxation, of spiritual rest. So in this book, Relaxing with God, I'm talking about how really the only fruit bearing that we can do comes from an attitude of rest. Are you a person that has been resisting a rest in Christ? Are you willing to rethink that? Are you willing to go on a journey with me as we look at the depths of God's love for us and how we can truly relax with Him and rest in the finished work of Jesus Christ? You know, there's really no other way to live the Christian life. It's a paradox. It's absolutely a paradox in that we could never imagine that the whole thing could come from a place of doing nothing. Are you willing to do nothing to get right with God? Are you willing to do nothing to stay right with God? You know what doing nothing to get right and stay right means? It means justification by faith. It means that we believe that we're already right with Him. And from that place, that attitude of dependency on the finished work of somebody else, from there, the Christian life begins to unfold and we truly bear fruit for God. Join me on this adventure as we learn to relax with God.